A very good morning, children. Today we are going to continue with the chapter banking and the banking transaction. Okay, in this chapter we had done in the previous class about the central bank. Central bank, it is the apex institution of our country's monetary and banking structure. It is owned by the government. Okay, it is bankers to the government and also to the other banks in the country. It controls credits, isn't it? This is what we have done. And it keeps cash reserves, grand financial recommendations. Okay. And what is the name of the Central Bank of India? It is known as RBI, the Reserve Bank of India. And the chief office, it is known as, he is the governor. Okay. So, and what are the functions of the Central Bank? The main functions we had done. In today's class, I'll be explaining you the different basic types of banks and the banking transaction. Okay, so let's start with the bank account. They are classified into four types: current account, saving account, recurring deposit account, and fixed deposit account. Okay, now what is current account? Current account is mainly for business persons, firms, companies, public enterprises, and are never used for the purpose of investment or savings. These deposits are most liquid deposits, and there are no limits for number of transaction or the amount of transaction in it. Transaction means what? The first thing which we should know is, what is transaction? You'll ask me, isn't it? Transaction means anything which we deal in terms of money. That is known as transaction. So current account, it is usually done by the business persons. Okay, and they do the interaction unlimitedly, day to day activities. They deposit money, they take out money, they give checks and all. That is known as a current account. Okay, and there is no interest paid on amount held in the account. Bank charges certain services charges. They have some account. Okay. And they don't have any fixed maturity, as there is on continuous basis. Okay, so this type of account is usually used by the businessmen. Okay, the second is, what is saving account? Saving account is meant for saving purpose. Any individual, either single or jointly, can open a saving account. Most of the salaried person, pensioners, and the students have saving account. The students, if they are, they have to keep a person who is already there in the bank, who should be mature enough, who they will only be as a nominee there. Okay, and the advantage of having saving account in a bank is that you get interest, a nominal amount of interest. Rate of interest ranges between 4 to 6% in India, but now because of this lockdown, the percentage has gone down to around 3%. There is no restriction on the number and amount of deposits, but withdrawals are subjected to certain restrictions. Some bank recommends to maintain a minimum amount to keep it functional. Yes, there are some government banks, and there are also commercial. The commercial banks are a government and also private banks, isn't it? So they have their own amount, minimum deposit. Like you have 1,000 rupees in a government bank and more than 5,000 in the private banks, right? Then next is your recurring deposit. What is recurring deposit? It is also known as RD. It is opened by those who want to save certain amount of money regularly for a certain period of time and they want to earn a higher rate of interest. Means whatever you get in saving accounts, you get here more than that. Okay. In RD account, a fixed amount is deposited every month for a specific period, and the total amount is repaid with interest at the end of the particular fixed period. After certain time, you know, it is you have to, like, it minimum it is for 6 months. Like what happens is, like, for example, today is 3rd of June. So if I open an account and I keep this recurring deposit for 1 year, then the money will get matured next year, 2021 June, same date, 3rd, and every month I have to deposit the amount, minimum amount of money. Like it starts from 500,000 rupees. So every month on the same date you are supposed to deposit the amount in your account. And if you have a salaried account, then your money directly from the RB, from the salary, it goes to the, you can do such arrangement that it goes directly to your recurring deposit account. Okay? And you can also sometimes, you can take out the money due to urgency before your maturity time, but you will not get the interest. You know, it will be of no use keeping in the account, in the bank. Then a very important type is fixed deposit account. Okay, that is known as FD account. Usually people do it. And what happens is that is you keep that money for a particular period of, you don't have to give it every month. Like you have a lump sum amount of money, maybe a 5,000 or a 10,000, and you keep it for 1 year. Nowadays even you can keep it for the like some days, number of days, and you get it. And you know, fixed deposit before, there are two types of fixed deposit. In fixed deposit, what happens, in some of them you cannot take out the money in between, but in some banks they are giving, nowadays they are giving the facility of sweep-in deposit. That is, now if you keep it for a particular time, you get the interest of fixed deposit, which is higher than the recurring and the saving deposit. Okay, and then you can also take out the money whenever required. That is the facility, now the new facility given by the bank. I am getting my point. And but then you will get the particular rate of interest of fixed deposit only for the time period or the tenure you have kept it in the bank without taking it out. Once you take out the money, then the number, the interest rate reduces. Okay. Now, what is a bank transaction? I explained you, bank transaction is a record of money that has moved in and out of a bank account. Okay. You have ATM. Children, tell me the full form of ATM. What is the full form of ATM? Automatic teller machine. Isn't it? In which you, through the machine, 24/7 in the ATM counters, you can deposit money and you can also withdraw money. Then charges, record a purchase on a credit card. You can record a purchase on a credit card or withdraw funds using a debit card. Like for example, the ATM card which you have, no, that works as a debit card also. You go to any place where they are using the machine, you can pay the amount, or you can make use of the credit card which is also provided by the bank. Credit, what is credit card? It is a card which is given by the bank. It has a limit and you can do the purchasing by using that credit card, and you have to pay interest and you have to keep paying back the money. You know, people usually generally, we mediocre family, we don't prefer credit cards, because then what happened, we get used with, we don't have any idea, you know, how much shopping we have done or how much money has been used up, and the rate of interest is very high. Okay. Then deposit, we add funds to an account by any method, you know, that is ATM you can use checks, and then you might have seen checks. Withdraw funds by writing a paper. In a paper, you write the check. You find that the cash is always, it is not, it is very dangerous to carry the cash. So you take a checkbook along with you. Now the easiest thing is ATM card. But you take a check. You can just, in that paper, you write the amount and to a particular person. Then that person can only take the money out of it. Then online withdrawal. Nowadays, you have got net banking. That is the best method. Now in the lockdown, that most helpful one, isn't it? Then withdrawal funds from point of sale transaction. POS is point of sale, typically a cash or a debit card purchase is done. Then transfer money funds from one account to the another. That also can be done. Withdrawal deduct from an account by any method. Okay? These are the